Assalamu alaikum girls. The topics for today week is the same, the nervous system, but half of the chapter we have discussed in the previous week. The remaining we will discuss in this week. The week is third week, 20 April to 24th April. Everyone is fine and doing good at home, is safe and helping your mothers at home. I hope everyone is good. So today I am going to discuss with you first of all the lesson plan. The lesson plan for this week is spinal cord, reflex arc, reflex action and past whooper. We will discuss all these subtopics one by one. So before starting with the formal explanation, I would like to share with you the objectives which we have to achieve during this week. The objectives are that by the end of the lesson you will be able to describe the structure of spinal cord, describe role of spinal cord in coordination and control. You will be able to differentiate between sensory and motor neuron. You will be able to define reflex arc and reflex action, and will be able to differentiate between voluntary and involuntary actions. So I am going to explain you. The first part is internal structure of cerebrum and cerebellum. I have discussed with you the structure of cerebrum and cerebellum one by one. Now I am going to start with the internal structure of cerebrum. As you know that outer layer is made up of gray matter which consists of nerve cell bodies. Inner layer is consists of nerve fibers and is in white color and is called white matter. Previously I have discussed with you medulla oblongata, which is the third part of the brain. Outer layer is made up of white matter while inner layer is made up of gray matter. Now I am moving towards today's topic, that is internal structure of spinal cord. Now spinal cord arises from the last part of the brain, that is medulla oblongata, and runs through the backbone. Now internal distribution of the nerve cell body is similar to the medulla oblongata, which is the outer cortex contain white matter while the inner cortex is in H shaped and contain gray matter. In the central region of gray matter is a central canard and filled with cerebrospinal fluid. Reflex center for controlling involuntary action, and it also contain transmit impulses to and from brain. These are the main parts of the spinal. Now structure of spinal cord. It is consisting of two portion, one is gray and the other is white matter. Gray matter is inside surrounded by white matter. Now this is the difference between the brain and the spinal cord, that its gray matter is inside and white matter is outside. Now in spinal cord, gray matter is inside and white matter is outside. Gray matter has the shape of the letter H, and the narrow central canals run through the middle of the spinal cord. This canal contains a fluid known as cerebrospinal fluid, and it is responsible for giving nutrients to the spinal cord. That means its function is to provide nourishment. If in the diagram you can see that it is making an H-shaped center, and in the center there is a central canal. White matter is outside and gray matter is inside, which is making the H cell. And from this gray matter arises the spinal nerves, as you can see in the diagram. Now structure of the spinal nerves. Spinal nerves define into two roots, dorsal root and the ventral root. Now dorsal root join the dorsal part of the spinal cord, contains sensory neurons. Cell bodies of the sensory neurons are clustered together in small swelling known as the dorsal root ganglion. Axon of the sensory neuron end in the gray matter of the spinal cord, whereas their dendrons are located in the dorsal root and the Now ventral root joins the ventral part of the spinal cord, contains the motor neurons. Dorsal root contains the sensory neurons. Now ventral root contains the motor neurons. Remember this, cell bodies of the motor neurons and dendrons of the motor neurons, it lies in the gray matter of the spinal cord. To enter the ventral root and spinal nerve contain nerve fiber from both the dorsal root. Now ventral root, which are motor neurons actually, as the spinal nerves leave the spinal cord, it progressively subdivided into branches and supplying nerve fiber to various parts of the Now nervous tissues, I have explained you nervous tissue previously as well. But just a reminder, it is made up of nerve cells called neurons and basic unit of nervous system. There are three types of neurons: sensory neurons, motor neurons, and neurons. You can see in this diagram the structure of the sensory neurons, that is, they are taking messages from the sense organ and passing it on to the dorsal root of the cell body, and then taking these messages to the central nervous system. Then motor neurons, they are present in the gray matter. They are taking the messages and passing to the effectors. Relay neurons are present in between these two neurons, sensory and motor neurons, and motor and central nervous system. Now, structure of the neurons. This is that how impulses travel from one in the sensory neurons, that receptors, dendrites of the receptor receive the stimuli, passing into to the axon, and then it is carrying to the cell body, and then nerve ending and passing them to the central nervous. Function of the neuron is to transfer nerve impulses from neuron to another neuron across the synapse, and you know that synapse is the space between the two neurons, or the junction between the two neurons. And in effectors such as muscle or gland, when the sensory receptors are stimulated, a nerve impulse is produced and carried by the sensory neuron. Nerve impulse is transmitted to the relay neuron located in the spinal cord of the brain, and the cell body of the motor neuron receives the information from the relay neuron. Axon of the motor neuron carries the nerve impulse to the effector organ located out of spinal cord. In this diagram, you can see that brain from the medulla oblongata, spinal cord is arising and running in the vertebral column. Then there are nerves carry information from the brain to the body. Sensory nerves information from the organ to the brain, and motor nerves from the information from the brain to the spinal cord. And you can see it through this. Now, gray and white matter. There is a differentiation of the gray matter in cerebrum and cerebrum. Gray matter is outer region and white matter is inner region. While in spinal cord and medulla oblongata, inner region is the gray matter and outer region is the white. Sensory neurons, there is a more detail of the sensory neurons, that they receive the stimuli, taking the impulses through at the nerve ending and travel down to the axon to reach the end of the cell. There is a myelin sheet present around these nerves, which are helping to speed up the electric impulses, and then electric impulses reaches to the relay neurons that are in spinal cord. Then motor neurons, they have cell body. You can see in the diagram beginning of the dendrites, they are radiating outside, and pulses received from the relay neurons which travel to the axon and reaches the motor end plate, and that is embedded in the muscles, and they will cause the track. Now there is a new terminology which you come across, is a reflex arc. The previously we were discussing that stimulus is being detected by the sense organ, and sense organ passing the messages to the sensory neuron carry them to the central nervous system, and whatever central nervous system order, it is conveyed through the motor neurons to the effectors or muscles and glands. Now these are voluntary actions which are under the control of our central nervous system and our own will, but there are some actions which are occurring at once or quickly. So these actions are called actually reflex arc. It is a neural pathway between the receptor and the effector involved in the reflex action. Now example is a knee jerk reflex, which is a sudden response of the knee when it feels any kind of sudden attack or sudden. Then what is reflex action? Involved message being transmitted from the sensory neurons to the motor neuron directly without involving the conscious part of the brain. A reflex arc is the shortest pathway by which impulses travel from the receptors to the effector in a reflex action. For example, if a needle pricks in your finger, you suddenly withdraw your hand. That is a reflex action. In this, sensory neurons directly pass on the message to the motor neuron, and the muscles of the hands withdrawn by the single prick of the needle. This is reflex action. In this, the conscious part of the central nervous system is not involved. Central Reflex action is the immediate response to the specific stimulus without conscious control. These are controlled by two reflexes center, the brain and spinal cord. The two spinal reflexes controlled by the spinal cord, like knee jerks, and cranial reflexes controlled by the brain, that is salivation at the sight of the food. Salivation occurs, that is the cranial reflex. Cranial means directly from brain. Here I am showing you certain reflexes like blinking, knee jerk, yawning, coughing and secretion. Or these are the receptors and effectors which are involved, and these are reflex action in which are involuntary, in which they are occurring automatically and central nervous system is not involved and they are not our conscious control. I think they are receptor through which they are being detected, and effectors which are involved in showing the response and what kind of response occurs. You can see this. Now I have been sharing with you and I have been discussing with you voluntary and involuntary action. So voluntary and involuntary actions, voluntary actions require thinking. They are under your own control and will, like movement of your hands and movement of your legs, walking, sitting, sleeping. Involuntary action without thinking, like blinking of the eyes, heartbeat, withdrawal of the hand on the pricking of the needle. Then voluntary actions are slow, they take times, but involuntary actions always occur faster. Controlled mainly by the brain, and involuntary action controlled mainly by the spinal cord, and voluntary actions are everyday action, and usually life-saving actions are involuntary. Involuntary and involuntary actions are clear to you, and they are more clear through this flow chart. Receptor receives stimuli. Sensory neurons carry messages, nerve impulses to central nervous system. Central nervous system passes these impulses to the cerebrum, and then motor neurons carry impulses to the effector. These are voluntary action, which are slow and takes time and under our own control or will. Now, knee jerk reflex. At the receptor receives stimulus. In this case, tapping stimulates tendon of kneecap. Sensory neurons from the dendron, sensory neuron, nerve impulse fired off across the synapse. The motor neurons through dorsal root of the spinal nerve carried to the spinal cord. Impulses jump across the synapses to the motor neurons in gray matter, but in other reflex action. So to the effector, now the order is passed to the effector from the synapse, that impulses are further transmitted through the central root to the effector to produce response. As you can see, in this whole process, central nervous system is not involved. Only sensory neurons are passing it on to the spinal cord, and spinal cord is directly giving message. Motor neurons which are passed on to the effector. Now here you can see that what are the receptors, sensory neurons, associated neurons and motor neurons, how they are keep on passing the messages. And you can see that sensory neurons are taking messages from the receptors and they are passing on it directly to the effector through the synapses. Now dorsal and ventral root are more clear to do. Reflex action, like you can see here, pain receptor, by taking the matchstick near your finger, when you feel the pain, they are going through the sensory neurons to the cell body of the dorsal root. This is pass on to the central nervous system, gray matter, and then pass on to the synapse, and order comes through the motor neurons to the effector. And what is the order? Withdrawal of the hands on feeling the pain when the matchstick is brought to you. This whole pathway is called reflex arc, which is taken by the sensory neurons to pass on the message to the motor neurons. Here, this is action. Spinal reflexes can occur in deep sleep, so do not depend on awareness, but impulses can still pass from sensory neurons up to the cord to the brain. Then other reflex action like blinking, coughing, sneezing and cranial reflex action takes place in the medulla. Now this is a comparison between reflex and the voluntary action. This is again a difference between the voluntary and involuntary action. Actually, reflex actions are the involuntary actions and voluntary actions. I think they make you more clear how which path is taken by, how they are controlled, speed of the response and response to the stims. So always any sudden response is a reflex action in which our own control or will is not involved, and voluntary action is always our control or under our. I think by the end of the lesson I would be able to describe you the structure of spinal cord and the role of the spinal cord in coordination and control, and difference between the sensory and motor neuron, reflex action and reflex arc, and voluntary and involuntary action. I think I have made myself clear. Stay safe, stay happy, and if you have any query you can discuss with me. And in this week resource I have given some past papers question and some links as well. You can do them, and if you have any query please note them down. When we will resume the classes we will discuss with you. Thank you so very much.